A treatment for Alzheimer's disease remains elusive, and so does an effective way of dealing with some of its worst symptoms, like agitation and aggression. But as Connecting Point's Arun Rath reports, one family in Eastern Mass found medical marijuana helped significantly. Now they're funding a study to determine if it could work for others.
Greg Spear's dad, Alex, lived an amazing life.
He was a prisoner of war during World War II. He fought for the Dutch underground army and was captured at basically 14 and a half, 15 years old, and spent 3 years in the concentration camps. He survived because he learned to be a watchmaker. He used to fix watches for the German soldiers in exchange for food and water.
After the war, Alex Spear turned from the nightmare of the Holocaust to the dream of America, bringing nothing but that skill with watches to start a jewelry store, raising a family, and then making his fortune in real estate.
It was a life well lived, it just didn't end well.
Alzheimer's disease saw to that. Alex Spear spent the last year of his life in rapid decline, progressing quickly from memory loss to more difficult symptoms like agitation and aggression, and the delusion that he was reliving the nightmare of the concentration camp.
It was just horrible to see those sort of memories that had been suppressed his entire life coming back.
When nothing else worked, a family member suggested trying medical marijuana.
The first night that we gave it to him was the first night that he slept through the night in I'd say weeks. It was remarkable. You know, whatever time we had with him, you know, with a significant dementia patient, if you get the glimmer of hope every once in a while to see that, you know, your loved one is still around is really a special time.
The family's experience was of particular interest to Dr. Brent Forrester, who had completed a study showing the active ingredient in marijuana seemed to reduce agitation in a small group of dementia patients.
The FDA, to this day, has never approved a single medication to treat any of the behavioral symptoms of dementia. Any medicine we would use to help calm or reduce those symptoms is all off-label.
And when it comes to marijuana, there's no federal funding for medical research.
I kind of felt it was like a trial and error, with my father being kind of like the human guinea pig.
But long before he got sick, Alex Spear started a charitable foundation that supports medical research. The Spear Family Foundation is now funding a study Dr. Forrester will design that will explore marijuana as a treatment for the behavioral effects of dementia.
My father kind of lived his life, and one of his little mottos was, I want to leave the world a better place than I found it.
Between the Holocaust and Alzheimer's, life took a lot away from Alex Spear, but even in death, he's found a way to give a lot back.